Welcome to where I call home. I've been roaming these parts since I was old enough to, well, roam. There isn't a mountain or lake out here that hasn't been explored by either me or my dad. I hope that you get a chance to fall in love with Silver Ridge Peaks. If you're anything like me, it won't take long. Morning. I hope you got a chance to grab a big breakfast before heading out. There's a lot of ground to cover and it's tough on an empty stomach. Anyway, I'm sure you'll be glad to know that I already have a job for you. While things are quiet, I've been using our outpost to store essential supplies. There is an outpost not far from you that has a small stockpile of bottled water and canned goods. I need you to grab some things from this outpost and ferry them over to one of our observation towers. Don't worry. It's not a long journey. You'll be back to hunting in no time. Before now, we've always just used the lakes for drinking water. But ever since Dad got ill, we've had to put emergency measures in place. We always had emergency supplies, of course. But now we need to account for the possibility that our entire water table is polluted. Dad and I are convinced that it's just the one lake, polluted by the old mining sump next to it. But it's taking forever to get tests done, and it's not worth the chance of someone else getting sick. This is the place. The supplies should be laid out, ready for you to pick them up. We need at least 6 water bottles, a couple of cans of peaches or whatever we've got there, and there should be a stack of flyers. Grab them too. Everything? Fantastic. The tower isn't too far to go from here.
Tracks are my go-to source for insight into animals in the reserve. Species, number, mood, you can learn a lot about them before you've ever spotted anything. I've been hunting mule deer for 20 years, but let me tell you, they still find ways to surprise me. They'll hear you coming from a good way off if they haven't already picked up your scent. Lucky for us, it's hard for them to camouflage themselves in the green meadows of Colorado. Now's your chance. My plan of attack: stay calm, wait for the animal to stop moving, and line up your shot. Do everything in your power to make a quick, clean kill. Enough blood and you know you've hit a vital organ. If you're taking good shots with the right weapon, there's bound to be something waiting for you at the end of that trail. Any reason to come find you. You might not live to tell the tale. pronghorn is the fastest land mammal in North America. They're not as sensitive to noise as some of the other animals in the reserve, but they trust their eyes, so stay down and hidden to prevent them from bolting. Black bears are the smallest bear species on the continent, but that's not much of a comfort when one's charging you at 30 miles an hour. I'm sure you know to always keep a loaded gun handy.
You found the tower. There's hopefully a free shelf inside, somewhere you can stash the supplies. Oh, you should hang on to a couple of the flyers, though. Fantastic. That tower should have everything it needs now. How's the view from up there? It's great to have a hunter like yourself around. I'm grateful for your help with the supplies. I can't wait to hear your Silver Ridge hunting stories. Things have been quiet here recently. But with a hunter of your caliber on the reserve, we're gonna show folks that this is still the best place in the Rockies to hunt. Plus, you're not the only one working with us. We were able to convince Remy Warren to visit, and he's been logging his solo hunts out here for a week or so. He's got a pretty decent following online, so hopefully he's impressed with the reserve. When I proposed using social media to promote the reserve, the board were a little hesitant. But they're giving us a chance to try something new, and I'm sure it'll be worth it. So I suppose you were wondering why I wanted you to grab the flyers, right? There are people who come out here just to visit the lake. I'm fine with people standing on the shore, but until we know exactly what's going on, we need to keep people out of it. I had these flyers made up so we can pin them to our bulletin boards. There's a trail that leads straight to the lake, so I'd like you to pin up one of these flyers at the trailhead. Now, the flyers cover the basics, heavy metals, mining waste, and why to avoid diving in. It's not much, but until we know more, it's all we have. The lake is beautiful, and it's always pulled in visitors. It still looks the same as it ever did. Maybe even better, now that it's calm and peaceful. But now, I can't look at it without seeing what it did to my dad, or what it's doing to the reserve. People discover that we have one contaminated lake and assume that the reserve isn't worth visiting anymore. So far, the local wildlife seems okay. But our bookings for visitors, and especially hunters, have dried up. I have a few contingency plans that I want to try out. I'm a little nervous, though, as our board can be a little conservative. And if my ideas don't involve pulling in hunters, it can be really tricky to get them on board. It was easier to convince the board to invite yourself and Remy into the reserve, given that you're both hunters with good reputations. I'm glad you said yes. One down, one to go. Keep following the trail to the lake. Take a look at the water. If I hadn't told you, would you suspect that the lake was dangerous? We might not be able to monitor the lake 24/7, but at least now people have been warned. Thanks for taking care of that. It's such a strange feeling to be publicizing the very issue that is hurting us at the moment. I know it's the responsible thing to do, but it still feels slightly like self-sabotage. Our summer season has already started, and normally, this whole area would be covered with hikers. I've only seen a handful of people in the reserve recently. I'm sure that things will pick up eventually, but every day, I'm reminded that my dad was the major driving force behind this place. It's just bad timing, I suppose. We'd had some other issues with one of the board members, but that's in the past. The best thing to do is to keep pushing forward. I've got some big plans to help turn things around. Who knows? Maybe we'll have this place at full strength by the time my dad gets back in the saddle. I'm talking a lot about family stuff, aren't I? I suppose work and family are the same thing for me, you know? I've been watching my dad do this job since I was a kid. Let's change the subject, shall we? I've got a job that I'd like you to take care of. The big plans I mentioned before? One of these plans is a little passion project of mine. We're gonna need some gear. Repelling gear, actually. I have stashed a few bags at one of the nearby outposts, and I'd like you to head over there and pick them up. When you can. I've been doing adventure sports for about 10 years or so now. It started with bouldering and rock climbing while I was on a high school trip. Last year, I got an accreditation as an instructor, and I was planning on teaching classes. When my dad got ill, I put it on the back burner. But now, I think we have a good opportunity to commit to it. Unfortunately, I'm a little too busy to teach classes just now. But one of my base jumping friends, Sammy, took the same course as me. So she's gonna lead the class instead.
Wild turkeys are nothing like their domestic cousins. They're fast, agile, and can even fly short distances when spooked. You might not have much luck stalking these birds, so try using a turkey collar to get them to come to you. Even a black bear won't take on a fully grown bison lightly. They're awesome creatures, and you should treat them with respect if you want to live to tell the tale.